Welcome guys, in this new lecture of Python programming series, we are continuing with our ongoing lecture that is lists in Python. And up till now, we have seen all the methods and attributes which lists support. Today we are going to see two important concepts which are important for your interviews. Now this is flattening of list and enumerate function. Now flattening is a term which is used to generate a single list by merging so many lists. Or the term is equally applicable for nested list. A nested list is something which is a list within list. So by flattening a nested list, we mean that we want to remove that nested parts and create single list by merging all the elements of a list. Like here, I have got a nested list. There are three lists within a list. And how to access a list element? We know that if I write A0, this will give me the 0th index value. See here. Similarly, if I write A1, it will give me the first index value. So to flatten or to create a single list by merging, I'll use concatenate or plus operator. And I'll write all the nested index values, A0 plus A1 plus A2, and see here. It has created a single list. Now the drawback is that if there are so many lists, up to say 100, then this method can be cumbersome. A0 plus A1 plus A2 plus A3 plus up to A100. To avoid this, we can use another method, another technique, say, that is using sum. So I'll write sum, in bracket I'll write list name, comma, and then I'll write a square bracket with nothing in it, that is an empty square bracket. If I run this, see here. So this method is quite handy. And you have, this is just a shortcut type method. This is not a standard method. This is a shortcut you have to remember. If you have more than one list, simply write all those lists by using concatenate operator. It will create a single list by merging all lists. Okay, moving on. Another task is to, I have got a list here of names and I have to print the index value and the corresponding list element. That is, for Tony, for Steve, Thor, Bruce, Stephen, I have to print the corresponding index also. 0 Tony, 1 Steve, 2 Thor, 3 Bruce, 4 Stephen. So how to do this? First, I'll write for X and D. Now this X can be Tony, Steve, Thor, Bruce, Stephen. So I'm checking. If X is in D, print that X. If X is in D, print X. So if Tony is in D, print Tony, Steve. So this I've got the elements list. Now how to get the index value? Now see, index is numeric position, numeric digit. It is 0, it is 1, 2, 3, 4. So what I'll do now, I'll use the len function. I can write here for x in range 0, 5. It will run from 0 and it will reach up to 4. But if my list is pretty long, suppose there are 100 elements or there are unknown number of elements, then what will happen? I'll write for x in range length d, it will start from 0 and it will go up to the length of the list. So see here, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 has been printed. Now what I'll do, I'll print the index position and the element position by writing D and in bracket 0, 1, 2, 3 or X. Now what happened? X is 0, then it will also print D0. D0 is Tony. X is 1, then D1. X is 2, D2. X is 3, D3. And our task is done. Another way to do this is by using enumerate function. Enumerate is a method, is a function which gives the index as well as element value. Let's see how to use this. Enumerate is a keyword, so I'll write enumerate. I'll pass the list name here also. And now I need two variables because I need two outputs. I need index and I need the value. So I need two variables to hold these two things. So I'm writing for x, y in enumerate d. This x will hold the value, index position, and y will hold the element lying at that index position. See here. we can also change these index position into a serial number. Suppose I want to start my index position from 2, not from 0. Then in enumerate, along with the list name, I can write d comma 2 here. And when I run this, this list will now start from 2. So basically it has now converted into a serial number instead of index position. Like here it is 2 Tony, 3 Steve, 4 Thor, 5 Bruce, 6 Stephen. If I write 100, it will start from 100. So now it has been converted in sort of serial number and not the index position exactly. So this is the basic operation of enumerate function. It is a very powerful function, and in coming lectures we'll be using more of this to see how to use enumerate, how it is useful. So thank you for attending this lecture. This was all about this lecture of flattening and enumerate. This is more of an interview sort of question. Keep practicing, keep commenting if you have any doubts. We'll meet in the next lecture. Thank you.